Mr. Orthopedia here with another episode of Walk Me Through. We're going to walk you through Super Paper Mario for the Wii. This game is the third in the Paper Mario series and was originally planned to be released on the GCN. So, this game, unlike the first two, has a real-time battle system. You're basically playing an action RPG, so let's shut our word hole and let's move on, shall we? So, let's get this started, shall we? Okay, boys and girls, let's give our file a name. Besides Bowser, have kidnapped the princess before. I can see they kind of recycled some of the artwork scenery from Paper Mario The Thousand Year Door, which again was for the GameCube.
Thank you.
Alright, boys and girls, this is a trans-dimensional world. And here we have a void. Very cryptic for a Mario game, don't you think? This is a pure heart. I like the way how it radiates so beautifully like that. The ripples. Really interesting effects. I mean, the graphics of this game they're very much the graphics of a high-end GCN game. Much more so since the Wii happens to have the same graphics card as the GCN, if not more improved slightly. At best, Wii games can only be upscaled to about 480p, and I am actually upscaling this via the Elgato Game Capture software to 1080p. Of course, yeah. It doesn't look that good. It doesn't look good compared to games released in 1080p, but to me, resolution doesn't really matter. So you basically hold the Wii remote sideways, kind of like an NES controller, really. And you press up to activate doors and elevators like this. And you also press up to talk to people. So here we are in Flipside, a trans-dimensional world. And Tippy's going to show us the way to the first column. We're going to use this elevator to go up. Like I said, this is a trans-dimensional world. At first it may seem 2D, but later on you'll find out that there are 3D elements of this game. And here's the heart pillar. So let's walk up to it, press up, place the first pure heart, which in turn opens up our first world. And that's the way it's done. Now let's return to Merlon. Merlon. However you pronounce his name. Merlon. You know what's interesting? This multi-level city doesn't have a stairwell, just elevators. I mean, what would happen if there was a fire? I mean, you gotta think about that when you have a multi-story building with elevators. You gotta have stairs too. Oh, here's a save block. You bump your head against this to save your progress. And like many RPGs, you should save often because you only have one life. Oh yeah, Merlon is upstairs, so let's go ahead and go up. There he is. This is the return pipe. It's basically a one-way pipe. What it does is, it allows you to leave the worlds. There are some places where you can't use it. Yeah, there are places where the return pipe can't be used. So be aware of that. I mean, hey, there's no shame in running away from a battle. You know what they say, those who live and run away live to run away again. Okay, it doesn't go like that, it goes more like this. Those who fight and run away live to fight another day. Those who fight and run away live to run away again. That was actually what Jack Sparrow said from Pirates of the Carrots of the... Oh my god! Rencho, you have me saying the way you used to when you were a baby! Pirates of the Caribbean! My nephew Lorenzo, he used to say Pirates of the Carrots of the Beans! Oh my god! It was just so adorable!
Of course, at the time he said it, he was just a baby. Anyway, let's move on. Of course, this would be a good time to stop the video here. Anyway. In the next video, we're going to visit our first world. But until then, this has been Walk Me Through. I'm Mr. Orthopedia saying peace. And that's a wrap. See you soon.
Peace!